सलाम नमस्ते सलाम नमस्ते
Okay, so 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Salaam, Namaste, Nabbe Dashamlab Chaar, Samudayik Radio Station पर दोस्तों स्वागत है आपका एक brand new initiative में, एक नई पहल में और एक बहुत ही सकारात्मक positive पहल में. यहाँ हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि आप हेल्दी तो रहिए लेकिन हैप्पी हेल्दी रहिए, और ये तभी संभव है जब आपका दिमाग, अंतर्मन और बॉडी, माइंड, सोल, इनर, आउटर, इन एंड आउट सब कुछ हैप्पी हो. और उस हैप्पी क्वेश्चन को पाने के लिए देखिए इंसान क्या नहीं करता, और आपको करना क्या है, अपने आप को सिर्फ वो हैप्पी क्वेश्चन देना है. एंड द नेम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम इज द हैप्पी माइंड हैप्पी हेल्थ सिटी. एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी व्हेन आई से दैट यहाँ पर एक नहीं, दो नहीं, तीन मेंटर्स हमारे साथ होंगे. तो आप समझ सकते हैं कि हमारी जो कोशिश है वो उतनी तगड़ी है कि हम चाहते हैं कि ये जो दौर है जहाँ पर बहुत सारे आई वुड से यू नो माइंड सेट से हम लोग गुजर रहे हैं, हर एज का इंसान, हर वर्ग का इंसान, बहुत तरीके की, बहुत प्रकार की, और मैं कहूँगी किस्म किस्म के प्रकार की सोच का सामना कर रहा है. जो सोच का आप सामना करिए वो जिंदगी का सामना करना ही है, सोच का भी करना है, लेकिन उसे इस तरह से करिए कि नो प्रॉब्लम इज अ प्रॉब्लम एंड एवरीथिंग इज अ सोल्यूशन. एंड विद दिस द हैप्पी माइंड हैप्पी हेल्थ सीरीज आई एम वेरी हैप्पी हमारे साथ जो मेंटर्स जुड़े हैं और उनका परिचय उन्हीं के द्वारा होगा, मगर मुझे अपनी हिस्से की खुशी जरूर बांटनी है. लेट मी ऑल्सो कॉल ऑन देयर नेम. वी हैव अंतरिक्ष जी. हेलो अंतरिक्ष जी, कैसे हैं आप?
Hello, Barsha. I'm fine. Thank you.
And we also have the real warrior, and that is Ambika ji. Hello, Ambika ji. Kaisi hain aap?
How are you, Barsha? I'm so glad to be back with you again.
Yes, and I'm very super glad to have you as a champion in this series. And I'm sure we all will be able to make this program a very, very happening program and a part of everybody's life.
Absolutely, Barsha. We all work together for each other.
Now that we have come to you, we also have one more mentor, that is Dindya Chokji. And this program is in, joint friendly association.
बिल्कुल बर्षा, अद्यंत और आनंदा का कनेक्शन इसलिए हुआ क्योंकि आनंदा इज फोकसिंग कम्प्लीटली ऑन साइकोलॉजिकल एंड इमोशनल रिलेटेड इश्यूज. सो हियर वी ट्राई टू असिस्ट, डायग्नोस एंड हेल्प पीपल एट एन इमोशनल लेवल. And we also empower them to deal with their own emotions in future. ताकि बार बार उनको हमारे पास आना ना पड़े या किसी और के पास ना जाना पड़े.
जी.
And जैसे ही empowerment मिल जाता है किसी को, confidence अपने आप बढ़ जाती है.
जी.
पर क्या होता है, कई बार emotional problems हमें physically affect करने लग जाती है.
हाँ.
And obviously we are not the people who are much aware of the physical issues or the issues related with organs. And that is where Ananda comes into the forefront, because Ananda deals with energy-based treatments where there are no medicines involved.
Okay.
And when Adyant treats them, it becomes easy for those people to handle their own energies, and Adyant also explains to them how these energies work in the body.
Okay.
And Adyant is founded by Mr. Antariksh.
So, Barsha, I'm Antariksh, and I practice acupuncture, scalp acupuncture, Ayurvedic acupressure, Sujok, Marma, chromotherapy. And all these things, if you see closely, you know, all these things are related to energy at some level. So, we basically work with energy, and through energy, we heal ourselves. So, we use energy as a medicine, and that works for us in our favor and help us come out of our ailments. So we have a clinic in East Delhi, Mayur Vihar, that goes by the name Adyant Health. And we treat many issues that may range from acute to chronic, including cervical, sciatica, joint pains, asthma, rheumatoid arthritis, gastrointestinal issues, hormone disorders, I think that to name a few.
All the terms are, I would say, not so easy. And when you say that you deal with such intricate and a little complicated stuff, but it again rests on the shoulders of the mentor that they make it so easy so that lives become easier. So welcome to the brand new series of Happy Mind and Happy Health. And with this, we'll now introduce the topic. Aaj ka jo pehla vishay hai hum is series mein le rahe hai, wo hai stress. स्ट्रेस हमारी जिंदगी का बहुत कॉमन हिस्सा है, और स्पेशली जब आप लॉकडाउन का सामना कर रहे हैं तो स्ट्रेस का तो बहुत अच्छी तरीके से और स्ट्रांग तरीके से सामना कर रहे हैं। स्ट्रेस ऐसा है कि अब आप कहीं जा नहीं सकते, उसे ठुकरा नहीं सकते, उसे निगेट नहीं कर सकते, और अगर आप उसे एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर पा रहे हैं तो यही आती है प्रॉब्लम। तो सबसे पहला सवाल आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है वो है स्ट्रेस। इस शब्द से ही इंसान स्ट्रेस्ड हो जाता है, तो आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे हेल्प अस टू नो हाउ डू यू डिफाइन स्ट्रेस।
ओके, आई एम बिंदिया चू, काउंसलिंग साइकोलॉजिस्ट एंड रिहैबिलिटेशनल काउंसलर, एंड थैंक यू वर्षा फॉर इनवाइटिंग अस ऑन दिस शो। या स्ट्रेस इज अ वेरी कॉमन वर्ड, एवरीबॉडी से वी हैव स्ट्रेस। सो व्हाट इज स्ट्रेस? इफ आई एक्सप्लेन इन सिंपल वर्ड, things which we think are beyond our ability or situations which are out of our control give us stress. Agar main example do, if I have to reach somewhere and I am getting late and there is a traffic jam, that situation can also give me stress. Stress is a very normal reaction when we think we are not able to cope up with the pressure and situation. You know, jaise stress ka word aata hai na, to hamare dimag mein ek negative image aa jati hai, एक नेगेटिव सिचुएशन क्रिएट हो जाती है। तो क्या स्ट्रेस सिर्फ नेगेटिव सिचुएशन में ही होता है या सिर्फ नेगेटिव इफेक्ट ही देता है? नहीं, पॉजिटिव सिचुएशंस में भी स्ट्रेस होता है। अगर मुझे इस साल बेस्ट एम्प्लॉय का अवार्ड मिला है तो मेरी कोशिश होगी कि यार नेक्स्ट टाइम भी मैं ये अवार्ड लूँ, तो दैट सिचुएशन आल्सो गिव मी स्ट्रेस। एक टारगेट मुझे अचीव करना है जो मैंने लास्ट टाइम किया था, अब वो भी सिचुएशन में मुझे स्ट्रेस हो सकता है। And you know, stress also can keep us alert, motivated and to face the situation and help us to perform better. अगर किसी स्टूडेंट के एग्जाम आने वाले हैं और उसे बिल्कुल भी स्ट्रेस नहीं होगा तो क्या वो स्टडी करेगा? नहीं। क्या वो अच्छे मार्क्स ला पाएगा? नहीं। तो that time stress help us to create good marks. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि स्ट्रेस जो होता है सिर्फ नेगेटिव ही होता है या नेगेटिव सिचुएशन नहीं होता है, बट टूडे टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग इज स्ट्रेस, the things which are beyond our ability and create stress. You can ask me, is it possible if life without stress? So my answer will be no. But yes, stress can be good or bad, positive or negative.
Absolutely. And stress can be negative if you take it very, very heavily on yourself. Or if you have stress defined kar diya hai, so we would also request you to help us to know, how do we know that a person is स्ट्रेस? कई बार क्या होता है, जो गुमसुम का चुपचाप सा इंसान है, मे बी ही इज इन अ थिंकिंग प्रोसेस एंड ही इज लिटिल इंट्रोवर्ट, मगर हम चुपचाप और कम बोलने वाले इंसान को अक्सर स्ट्रेस्ड इंसान समझ लेते हैं। हेल्प अस टू नो व्हाट आर द सिम्टम्स टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट अ पर्सन इज स्ट्रेस्ड।
यस बरका, यू आर एब्सोल्युटली राइट कि हम लोगों में कई बार स्ट्रेस होता नहीं है, सिचुएशनल होता है, या दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ आवर पर्सनैलिटी कि मैं चुप रहती हूँ किसी किसी सिचुएशन में, लाइक सोशली अगर मुझे कहीं पर कोई चीज देनी है या कुछ लोगों को उस सिचुएशन में स्ट्रेस हो जाता है, तो देट इज नॉर्मल। बट अगर मैं सिम्टम्स की बात करूँ तो सिम्टम्स कैन बी फिजिकल, इमोशनल एंड बिहेवियर। इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द फिजिकल सिम्टम्स, तो विच वी नोटिस इन आवर बॉडी, लाइक एक्ने एंड पेन, हेडेक इज अ वेरी कॉमन सिम्टम। जब भी हम किसी स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन में होते होंगे, हमने अक्सर लोगों को कहते सुना है कि यार मेरे सर में दर्द हो रहा है, अपसेट स्टमक, डायरिया और कॉन्स्टिपेशन, ड्राइजीनेस and sweating palm. If I talk about the behavioral symptoms, the most common would be change in eating habit. Stressful situation में mostly हमारी eating pattern जो होता है वो change हो जाता है। कभी कभी मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा भूख लगती है, कभी मुझे बिल्कुल भूख नहीं लगती है। The next is change in sleep. Sleep pattern बहुत disturb हो जाता है, किसी किसी को बहुत ज़्यादा नींद आने लगती है, किसी किसी को बहुत कम नींद आती है। कुछ लोग कंप्लेन करते हैं कि अचानक मैं रात को जाग जाता हूँ, फिर दोबारा मुझे वापस सोने में प्रॉब्लम होती है। एंड जो कॉमन चीज़ें हम लोग नोटिस करते हैं, नील वाइटिंग, शेकिंग लेग्स, ये भी हम लोग बिहेवियर सिम्टम्स में नोटिस करते हैं किसी भी स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन में। इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द इमोशनल सिम्टम्स, तो एंगर, फ्रस्ट्रेशन, सैडनेस आर कॉमन सिम्टम्स। मैंने जो नोटिस किया, जब क्लाइंट हमारे पास आते हैं तो वो लोनलीनेस, फियर, वरी, अवॉइडेंस का भी कंप्लेन करते हैं। दे आल्सो कंप्लेन अबाउट मेमोरी एंड कंसंट्रेशन प्रॉब्लम, दे फॉरगेट थिंग्स, कैन नॉट कंसंट्रेट ऑन देयर वर्क। तो ये उनकी डेली लाइफ को भी अफेक्ट करता है, उनके परफॉर्मेंस को भी अफेक्ट करता है। नाउ आई एम श्योर दैट वी ऑल नोटिस दिस सिम्टम्स, बट नेवर थॉट इट कुड बी बिकॉज ऑफ स्ट्रेस। बट नाउ आवर लिसनर कैन आल्सो कोरिलेट दिस सिम्टम्स एंड नो they are stressed out or not.
Absolutely. And once you know that this is stress, I would say. So, तब हम अपने आप को तैयार कर सकते हैं कि we also need to be a little responsible. अंतरिक्ष जी और अंबिका मैम आपसे पूछना चाहेंगे, जो भी हमें जवाब दे दे, वो कैसे बताना चाहेंगे, what does a person go through undergoing stress? अगर किसी को स्ट्रेस है तो वो उसके अंदर क्या चल रहा होता है, क्योंकि बाहरी दुनिया तो बाहर का ही पक्ष देख रही है.
Yeah, you rightly said, Barsha, that we actually do not have many times option to run away from that. हमेशा हमारे पास ऐसा विकल्प नहीं होता कि हम लोग उस स्ट्रेस से बाहर भाग सकें. तो ऐसे केस में अगर हम स्ट्रेस के साथ पॉजिटिवली डील नहीं कर पाते हैं तो ये हमें नेगेटिवली इफेक्ट करता है. सो इट्स ऑल अबाउट क्रिएटिंग दैट बैलेंस. सो इफ आई हैव टू रियली गो इनटू दैट, आई वुड से अ स्ट्रेस आउट पर्सन गोज थ्रू मेनी साइकोलॉजिकल एंड फिजिकल चेंजेस एंड इश्यूज. एंड फ्रॉम साइकोलॉजिकल पर्सपेक्टिव, You may have about this confusion. You may feel irritated. You may have a sense of frustration whereby you don't know what to do. You're divided into two parts within your brain. One saying this, another saying something else. And as already explained by Bindiya, these issues work upon a psychological level. So they have to be dealt with at psychological level. Now, from a physical point of view, we experience various symptoms. Now, I would like to emphasize upon this that these are symptoms, and when we say symptoms, these are certain signs that we experience in our everyday life, and we develop a tendency, you know, Barsha, to ignore them. So, for example, they could be as common as headache, or acidity, or constipation, diarrhea, shoulder pain, neck pain, backache, body ache. We know from our everyday experiences, you know, when we are at office or any professional setup, you may find people complaining, you know, I have a backache and it's been continuing for days. And you simply pop in a pill sometimes. And often a person may not relate these symptoms with stress, and many consider these as issues of the body, right? Hence, it becomes very important that we understand how our bodies respond to when we are stressed out. I think Ambika may want to add in a little bit about this.
Yes. So we know that, you know, how a person behaves when a stress is happening. So Ambika ma'am, over to you.
Yes. So what happens is, if we are trying to correlate what Bindiya has already mentioned about frustration, and if now we are trying to look at it from a physical point of view, which Antarish just mentioned, so out of frustration, the person is confused and is not aware of what to do. And this eventually starts as a headache. And the moment you see somebody stressed out, the first thing you notice about that person, even if you are in a metro train or, you know, you're sitting in a public area, this person is immediately holding the forehead and sitting. And if you ask, you, that person would either say, mujhe sar mein dard ho raha hai, ya mera sar bhari ho raha hai. And here, as Antariksh mentioned, the person is unable to relate it with the stress he is going through. He is thinking or he feels that it is the headache that is causing. It is not the thought or the emotion he is going through. So this is exactly what a person under stress goes through. It's just that depending upon our body, upon our immune system, these things would vary. So we all could go through all the symptoms. We all could go through maybe one or two symptoms at a time. The other common symptom would be, again, Bindiya has mentioned about it, sweating palms. ये हम ज्यादातर बच्चों में देखते हैं. फिर जैसे ही टीचर ने डांट दिया, बच्चे का हाथ से पसीना निकलना शुरू हो गया. And then what do? We take the child to a skin specialist. I'm not saying that skin specialist is not important, but it has all started from the thought and the feeling the child got. So this is how people undergo various emotions, various feelings, and various physical problems due to stress, which is not managed.
जी, तो ये बड़ी कॉमन सी चीजें होती है. ये तो एग्जाम्पल बहुत ही कॉमन सा है कि हाथ पे पसीना आ गया और हम उसे डर्मेटोलॉजिस्ट के बाद पास लेकर जाते हैं ये सोचकर कि ये कुछ और स्किन की बीमारी है, नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट ये दिस हैज हैपेंड फ्रॉम विद इन.
Correct.
वो हम रियलाइज नहीं करते. अब क्योंकि मैम हम समझ गए कि और बिन्या मैम ने ये बड़े सारे इनपुट दिए हैं कि और हम ये डिस्कस कर रहे हैं कि स्ट्रेस जो अंडरगो करता है उसके साथ होता क्या है. अच्छा, लेकिन यहाँ थोड़ा अगर हम समझ लें आर देयर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्ट्रेस और दिस इज लाइक जस्ट वन स्ट्रेस, या उसके स्टेजेस होते होंगे, या वो यू नो नॉर्मल हैंडलेबल होगा या लिमिट्स के विदिन होगा? हाउ वुड यू एंड अंतरिक्ष जी लाइक टू डिफाइन, आर देयर डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑफ स्ट्रेस, हाउ डू यू डिफाइन देम?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, तो देयर आर डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑफ स्ट्रेस. I'm not going into telling which are the areas where stress will happen. I'm just focusing on the categories of stress. So if you want to categorize it, this is of three types. One is the simple stress that we all face on a day-to-day basis and for a very short term. So say for example, today we have a hectic day. How do I plan? And I'm sure, you know, you being a wonderful anchor has this thought going on in your mind off and on.
Absolutely.
But, yeah. But then what happens is like this stress eases off once you engage yourself in some meaningful activities. Maybe you are getting ready for your next recording and then you forget the stress. And you're able to handle the situation absolutely with ease and you accept the reality. You know you have 24 hours, you know you have to manage your time and you also know you have to prioritize. So although the stress came, it was taken care of by yourself and it went off. So this is a regular stress which we all have and which Bindiya kind of pointed out as positive stress. Now the second one is something that is connected to situations, and every time such a situation comes up, the stress appears and it stays on for a longer time. And Barsha, here I'm not using any of the technical terms because I really want all our listeners to understand, you know, each of these stress categories, because that is why we are doing this whole show, so that we help each other. So now the second stress, if I give a very simple example, a child gets stressed about the exam and this child is continuously thinking about the exam and the child is continuously talking about the exam. He talks to his teachers, he talks to his friends, he talks to his parents. Jahan mauka mile, bachcha sirf exam ki baat karta hai. And then the exams are over, but the stress goes off for some time. But kya hota hai? He's already starting to think about, okay, my now next exam would begin in a month. Dheere dheere that stress starts building up, getting closer to the exam. So this is now, if you see, the first one was for a very short duration. The second one is for a longer duration. But now is the third one, which I would like to talk about. This is much more stronger, and this happens when we are not able to control the second type of stress, which happened for a longer time, which means the situation is over. And now I'll again continue with the example of the exam. The child now continues to think about the marks. Exams to khatam ho gaye, par ab pata nahi mere kitne marks aayenge, pata nahi mere answer sheet pe kitne red marks honge. I don't know what the teacher would tell me. And now the child is wondering what would be teachers say, what would the parents say? Okay, now that my test papers have come, my next test will take place in another month or so. Maybe I have to give few entrance exams. I don't know if I'm prepared. So now this stress is slowly becoming a pattern for this child, and it starts affecting every area of this child, and this becomes a problem. And in this third type of stress, the individual is constantly under pressure. And he would keep complaining continuously. So, and then he keeps going back and working on the, you know, past mistakes that he has made. And now when this worry continues and when this becomes a habit, we call this as chronic stress. So this is the stress that needs immediate attention. So basically, if I just have to put the whole explanation into one point, it is stress on a shorter term, stress on a situational basis, which we can call as episodes, or stress on a longer term. So while small amounts of stress is helping us plan better, chronic stress stops us from achieving even the easy things in life. And I'm sure Antariksh may have a couple of words to tell about how it affects at an energy or a physical level, that the person forgets to take care of his body as well.
Yes.
Hi, Barsha. Yeah, so that's rightly said by Ambika, that chronic stress can actually cast havoc upon our entire body. And you know, I get many calls from people about children, especially since she is talking about children. So I would like to include an example of children as well, that they have issues that do not correlate with any disease. Say, for example, pain in the eyes. So some people may say that this could be glaucoma, but that actually is not, right? Or some allergy on the skin or the body, and the child undergoes a heavy treatment for allergy, and there is absolutely no result with that. So these are certain issues that we also see in children, not only in adults, but also in children. So we can see, you know, where the stress has seeped into in our everyday life. It is not just at the surface of the society or at the professional level. It is also at a deeper level.
Exactly. और इसकी depth जानने के लिए ही you need the mentor and the person who has expertise in the same. And thankfully we have mentors in Happy Health, Happy Mind who are helping us to know what exactly it may be and what mistakes do we do of not recognizing it. Now that we have understood कि stress के examples क्या होते हैं, जिसको stress है वो inside battle के through go through कर रहा है. So now that we have understood it at a good length, let us also understand, can stress be also very, very hazardous? If yes, then, you know, I think we should all be very, very alarmed about it. So requesting both of you, Antarikshi and Ambika ma'am, to help us to know this, how stress is hazardous to us?
Yeah, Basha. So, you know, I would like to start with something small here. Is stress hazardous? Absolutely yes. Ignoring stress is actually more dangerous. That is where the problems begin. So, you know, initially in our everyday life, since we all are stressed in professional life or whatsoever, even it could be academic or anything, there is always a performance issue that is associated with that. So initially, you know, the signs and symptoms are generally overlooked, and that creates problems. It may be, you know, a simple repetitive headache, frequent acidity, constipation, body aches, including aches of the arms. You know, arms and shoulders and neck are something that we usually ignore. Okay, aaj to kandhe mein dard hai, aaj haath mein dard hai, aaj pair mein dard hai, aaj neck mein dard hai. We take that as part of our everyday life. Ki agar hum kuch kaam kar rahe hain to ye to hoga hi hoga. Right? We think these are pure physical ailments. And tomorrow they'll go away. But do they really go away? One pain turns into another pain, and then another pain, until unless we are not able to work anymore, and that is when we generally wake up, right? So these are symptoms for which we get ourselves treated, but you know the problem is that the underlying issues are often overlooked and only become a concern when they become severe or they become chronic. For example, you know, we often take medication for headache or acidity, and we only figure out later on that there is no permanent relief. The symptoms are suppressed as long as we take that medication. And such medicines then begin slowly to show their own side effects upon the organs, which further adds to the existing imbalance of the body and mind. So you see, prolonged stress initially often affects our digestive and excretory system. And every organ is affected positively or negatively by our mental and emotional state. Longer the negative state, larger the damage. So more we ignore, the more damage there occurs in the body. For example, you know, stress is the leading cause for hypothyroidism or hypothyroid, a condition where you normally would find that people start gaining weight even if they drink water, and at least that is how they think, right? And I'm sure with our experiences, we know in most cases, the medication for hypothyroid continues lifelong. And unfortunately, the symptoms associated with it, like lethargy, fatigue, unwillingness to work or take any initiative, either remain as it is or they escalate with time. We at Advent Health have treated many cases of hypothyroidism, and generally the symptoms disappear within first week of treatment. And we shouldn't really call this a cure, because, you know, there was no disease to begin with. Hypothyroid, like any endocrine disorder, is a disorder of the endocrine system. our effort should be to bring it back to order. So there's no question of cure, there's no question of disease, it has to be brought back to order. And another common example, since we started about this, with stress is allergy of the skin. Just like I gave you an example of the child, here's an important thing to know. Many so-called skin allergies or skin-related allergies often show mirror image on the body. So for example, if someone has allergy on the upper arm of the hand, right? It will also reflect in the similar way on the upper right arm of the other hand. These, however, are not diseases of the skin, but symptoms of underlying organ and energy imbalance. And another example is that, you know, sometimes you may have seen people with reddish or dark patches on the cheekbones, and they go through various treatments. And they also show some kind of a mirror image. So if there's a dark patch on one side of the cheek, it will also be there on the other side as well. And we know any kind of skin treatment, no matter how much specialized it is, absolutely makes no difference. Coming back to the real issue here. So what happens if we overlook stress and issues caused by stress? The answer is they're often in front of us, in front of our eyes, but generally we overlook. Have you seen someone with asthma, you know, or rheumatoid arthritis or Alzheimer's? Alzheimer's condition, people forget about their own life. They don't even remember what's happening in their life. Life isn't the same anymore once we get into these stages where our own thoughts become so toxic, Barka, that our own body begins to degenerate from within. Stress is not only a state of mind, but also that of the body. And now you can see how it forms a vicious circle and how important it is to become it becomes to identify and address the underlying issues that cause these symptoms. The underlying issues was stress.
Exactly. It gives me, you know, goosebumps when you are explaining this and to imagine this. And this can really become very, very dangerous. And that we, you know, the moment we are discussing that it can be hazardous, I think we should also know that, you know, what can be the repercussions if stress is not attended in due time. So I'll request Ambika ma'am to help us in this.
Yeah, so when we talk about repercussions, Antariksh already spoke about the physical repercussions and, you know, how it can get so intense that we are not aware of how to come out of it. And the only solution or the only way we see is to have medicines. Again, you know, it is not that we should not have medicines, but we should try to keep medicines as the last alternative. So, we already spoke about symptoms. It would be really nice for each one of us to understand how these symptoms can be correlated with the way we think. And if we think that, you know, there is some kind of a correlation, then you see, you know, which part of your organ, which part of your body is getting affected. Where is it that you're finding problems? And now if we are unable to figure these out and we take it very lightly, we reach a stage where everything becomes chronic. Like I am trying to help a youngster who says that, you know, she has problems with sleep. So for her, it is purely problem with sleep. And when I began talking to her, after a 2-hour conversation, she could finally understand the stress that she was going through. And the stress was from day-to-day life. It was nothing which was very specific. It was just the overthinking pattern of exams that she had formed. And this is what encouraged me to take that example of exam as well. And now with, you know, many exams being postponed, I'm sure that many students and parents are going through the stress as to when would the exam take place and, you know, would we have enough time to prepare? Have I forgotten what I already prepared? So now these are all stress that are going unnoticed. The child is constantly thinking, somewhere the parent is constantly reminding the child to study so that, you know, the child gets the required percentage to get into a college of his or her choice and get the stream the child wants. And now the repercussion would be that the child is not able to sleep at night. He or she may be, you know, getting dreams of or nightmares of exams and seeing the report cards and whatnot. So this is how repercussions happen. And these repercussions could be continuous, which we do not realize ourselves unless somebody points it out to others. So through this medium of our discussion, I really hope all four of us are able to help all the students and all the parents in figuring out their own patterns, because, you know, self-help is the best help.
Absolutely. So correctly defined, and you're helping us to become a person who can do some self-help and a person who can help not only themselves but others also. And you know, it is always a very, very happy quotient when I interact with you. And I also wish that through the medium of radio, this happy quotient should come to the listeners. So with this, I'll request you and Antariksh ji again to help us. How can we derive the happy quotient here, you know, with the happy mind when stress is in question?
Right. So, you know, I would like to thank Antariksh the way he pointed out the vicious cycle part, because that was so well put across. Yes, so now since we're talking about happy mind and happy health equation, the first action we need to take here is break that vicious cycle. See, that's exactly what we are doing during the lockdown, right? We're trying to break the vicious cycle.
Yes.
Right. It is not that, you know, we should not meet each other, we should not talk to each other, but put a pause, put a break. Take a stand one step behind. So this is what we need to do here with stress as well. So if you look back at what Bindiya and Antariksh have already explained in, you know, beautiful terms, it is all that began with a thought which was not taken care of initially. So the first step is become aware of your thoughts. I'm deliberately saying this slowly so that each of us understand that our thoughts are very important, because it is our mind that drives our health and not the other way around. So once you're conscious about your thoughts, you will understand whether they are helping you or they are draining you. Also, are your thoughts getting into loops? You know, the vicious cycle that we're talking about, even thoughts can form loops. So if these loops are happening in your mind, these thoughts will not help you very much. Every time your chain of thoughts begin, are you having any symptom in your body, like what was mentioned earlier by my co-hosts? Are you having sweaty palms? Are you having a headache? Or are you having problem with digestion? Or at an emotional level, are you feeling angry, upset or sad? When you identify these patterns, it becomes easy for you to start replacing the unhelpful thoughts by helpful ones. Yeah, in the beginning, you would need help. And that is absolutely fine. None of us can live all alone in this world. So the most important point here is we must all know that we all have what it requires to have a happy mind and happy health equation. And it will differ from person to person. So something that will make you happy may not be the same thing for me. And it is absolutely fine. We are all different people. So if you understand that, understand what is going on in your mind, but you're unable to help yourself, you know, my humble request is please, please seek help from a professional. It is any day helpful rather than taking strong medication to start with. We all know that prevention is better than cure. So this is what you need to do. And, you know, I think I would hand over this mic to Antariksh to talk about the other things that will help us having a happy mind, happy health equation, because he is a person who is very well versed with the food habits and sleeping patterns and how that works at a physical and energy level.
Yes.
Thank you, Ambika. So it is rightly said, prevention is better than cure, and that's essentially what we should practice in our everyday life as well. And now take care of your diet, because what you eat affects your mood. At least once a week, make it a point that you eat something light during the entire day. Let your digestive system also get some rest. And you know, I would like to add something interesting over here, and that should be a thumb rule for all of us. you know, what we do in our everyday life. We generally do not take breakfast. Or even if you do, we take it in such a manner that it cannot qualify as a breakfast. We generally take in a hurry, which is we generally take, you know, one glass of milk and we're off to our work. And then our lunch takes place at 2 in the afternoon. And throughout the day, we're not able to eat anything proper. And then we come back and with that, we want to take a 7-course meal. And we take probably all kind of food stuff, all complicated, complex food stuff like milk and we can say non-veg at 9 or 10 o'clock at night. You know, Barsha, we know from our experiences at that time when we come back from our office or from our professional work, if somebody tells us, you know, go and take a walk for 10 kilometers at night, would we be able to do that? Absolutely no.
No.
And at that time, you know, Barsha, we expect our digestive system to run a mile, to digest all that food at night. What makes us think that our digestive system has extra energy and we don't? So this is absolutely important. This is fundamental. Your energy is not separate from your digestive system. Take care of that, because that will only take you further in life. When there is no energy, how will we move forward? So that happy mind, happy health equation starts from your digestive system as well. Take care of that. And be regular, at least one with one form of exercise. Eat a walk, yoga, or, you know, if you're fascinated by Zumba, jogging, or anything else. There should be enough movement given to your body, because body is meant to move and work. That is the fundamental nature of body. Make 5 minutes of conscious breathing in the morning and evening as a must. Let more oxygen get into your lungs. Let your body be nourished by what we call pranavayu. That is the fundamental of our everyday living. Let your mind be nourished with oxygen, because that is what keeps us alive. Now, keeping us alive is important, and also to take rest. So sleep is another important aspect, as it rejuvenates every organ of our body. And you're ready with a fresh, you can say, attitude in the next day. Your mind is fresh. It is ready to take up challenges of this for the next day. If you are still continuing with the backlog of previous day in your mind, how do you expect to face the challenges of the next day? Talk about success, happiness, good memories. Smile at every instance. You may get to smile. Spend time consciously with people without looking at gadgets. You know, gadgets always take attention away from us. And here we have an opportunity and time to bring attention to ourselves. And that is the whole idea of it, so that it completes a full circle. Look at the sky every night and teach the younger generation to do the same. Appreciate nature, because we are part of it. We are no more different than that. Again, coming back to where we began, think good thoughts.
So ma'am, now that we have discussed it at full length, that this is absolutely the responsibility of each one of us to co-help and, you know, co-grow and help the person particularly who is in stress. After all, everybody is facing a different kind of stress. So how would you like to, you know, define us and give us a way through that? All in the family, in society, friends, teachers, all have a responsibility to help the person who is in stress. How do we do it?
Yes, we all have our own roles and responsibilities individually and, as you said, you know, so rightly put, as a society. So, you know, the society could be looked at as family or friends or people external, internal, whichever way. So if we talk about roles, we all play multiple and overlapping roles in everyday life. You know, it becomes very important at this stage to keep that flexibility. Because what happens is, somewhere we have made a framework. Oh, okay. You know, as a parent, this is what I'm supposed to do. As a teacher, this is what I'm supposed to do. As a male, these are my duties. As a female, these are my duties. As children, this is what the child is supposed to do. No. Let's just forget all those boundaries. Let's just get that boundaries kind of diminished and slowly blurred, and get into that flexible limits. Now the question would be, how does being flexible help? Because the more flexible we are in our minds,
the more we seek help and accept help. Have we ever seen a person being able to live all alone? If that was easy, this whole, you know, lockdown and quarantine period would have never been so painful for people or stressful for people. So this is one time that is showing to us in reality that we are a society. We cannot live all alone by ourselves. So now coming back to the whole point that we're planning to discuss, you know, I'm giving you a little examples. While the lady of the house is taking care of the home, children and her own professional life, the other members also should understand that they too play a huge part in contributing in day-to-day activities. Maybe their contribution is in a different way, not exactly like one person would handle it. So flexibility will help us be at ease. Now, if we talk about responsibilities, our main responsibility, the foremost responsibility, is to take care of our own health. So I'm repeating it, to take care of our own health, which means try and not get ill and then do a dis-ease management by, you know, running to a professional and taking in some medicines and then fighting it out. So if we take the responsibility of our health, we would avoid many things. Again, this all begins from our thought. And, you know, we are sure that we all have experienced some effects of some medicines at some point in time or the other. So it is better to avoid that. Again, I'm not saying that we should not take medicines. Take medicines only when it is required and under the prescription of a professional doctor. Do not take a medicine only because somebody in the family or some friend has suggested. Maybe that medicine was prescribed for a friend or the family member for a particular reason. Maybe it may not work for me. It may just have some, you know, repercussion upon me and a severe side effect. So please stop taking medicine like toffees. And now if we come to the emotional aspect, many a times we do not talk about our stress amongst friends and family members, because we think that we may be seen as a weak person, and then after that others will not take you seriously, and then people would always keep advising me. So let me just not talk about my stress at all. But please let go of this thought and talk to somebody who is close to you. And as a person being in the circle, may it be a family member, may it be a friend, may it be a teacher, may it be a mentor, my request is, please listen to the person who wants to talk to you. We are all different. Maybe you can handle stress without talking, but I cannot handle stress unless I talk to somebody. So when somebody thinks of a particular situation as a challenge, I am thinking as the same situation as a stressful event for myself. So when I'm trying to talk, I'm just requesting for somebody to listen to me. So be that listener in somebody's life. So it is very important for all of us to be non-judgmental. And from my personal experience, I have seen that, you know, many a times when somebody just speaks their heart out and getting that assurance from someone else that, you know, you're being listened to, that, yeah, I'm here to listen to you, talk to me, that entire stress just gets relieved. See, that one conversation has helped a person so much. Isn't that any day better than having to undergo very typical professional help? Of course it is. So to put it in simple terms, please be aware of all your thoughts. Talk to someone who you think can help you, and if required, do seek help from a professional. And, you know, make being happy with simple pleasures of life a habit. We are all looking at bigger things, larger than life things. Start with looking at a simple butterfly flying. Start with enjoying the rains, because now Delhi has been getting rains very often. So let us start enjoying them instead of complaining, oh, again, fir se chip chip hone laga hai. Let's see, there is some water being sent down to earth. So remember that you are the one who thinks in your head. So think good thoughts, happy thoughts and harmonious thoughts. While stress is a part of life, like all of us have been discussing all this while, the more important aspect is to see how quickly we can come out of it. At Ananda Center of Counseling, we use simple visualization techniques and something called Emotional Freedom Technique Tapping or EFT Tapping to help clients come out of their stress, and also, we also teach them to use these simple techniques. So these techniques are used with other therapies or as standalone methods as required. And in case we feel that there is any issue that needs to be treated at an organ level, we seek help from Adyant Health and Antariksh comes to the rescue. So thus, we try to give a holistic approach to a client who approaches any of us, be it Adyant Health or Ananda Center for Counseling. So, you know, if you look at it from a positive way, what is life if there are no challenges? While challenges add fun to our life, don't let continuous stress cripple our life. So this is all I have to say today.
And Vindhya ji, now that we are speaking to a very, very renowned counselor like you, jiska expertise is rehabilitation, which is a very, very, I would say, not so easy topic. What is the role of a counselor in helping a person who is undergoing stress?
Yeah, as my co-host Ambika explained, if you are unable to help yourself, please seek help from professional. In that situation, please approach counselor and psychologist. Like, जब हमें कोई फिजिकल प्रॉब्लम होती है तो हमें पता है हमें डॉक्टर के पास जाना है. डॉक्टर हमारी प्रॉब्लम को डायग्नोज करते हैं एंड उसे ट्रीट करते हैं. उसी तरह जब हमें कोई इमोशनल प्रॉब्लम होती है तो हमें काउंसलर को अप्रोच करना है. काउंसलर हमारी प्रॉब्लम को असेस करते हैं, डायग्नोज करते हैं, देन दे वर्क ऑन एक्शन प्लान विद अस. इफ आई हैव टू टेल अबाउट द रोल ऑफ काउंसलिंग शॉर्ट, अ काउंसलर विल हेल्प द क्लाइंट टू अंडरस्टैंड हिज पैटर्न, work on them and also empower him with the future situation. In Ananda, between Ambika and me, we try to understand the best method that suits the client and empowers him after the therapy session. In case client needs help with any physical aspect, we suggest him to meet Antariksh of Adyant Health to get non-medical treatment done.
Yes, and with this, you know, a counselor becomes a friend, philosopher, guide to help us to beat stress. So, आपने बता दिया मैम बखूबी कि कैसे स्ट्रेस को पहचाने, क्या कब कैसे क्यों और कितना करें, कैसे काउंसलर के साथ भी आप अपना इक्वेशन बनाए रखें. चलते चलते लिसनर्स को क्या कहना चाहेंगे विज़वी स्ट्रेस?
मैं यही कहना चाहूंगी कि अगर आप पहले देखिए कि आपको स्ट्रेस है तो क्या रीजन है, क्या कॉजेज हैं, आप अपने फ्रेंड से, फैमिली से उस बात को डिस्कस कीजिए. एंड सेकेंडली, अगर कोई पर्सन आपके पास किसी प्रॉब्लम को लेके आ रहा है, कुछ डिस्कस कर रहा है, तो आप उसकी बात को सुनिए एंड एक न्यूट्रल लेवल पे सुनिए. बिकॉज हर किसी का सिचुएशन को देखने का, रिएक्शन करने का तरीका बहुत अलग होता है. अगर मैं एक एग्जाम्पल लूँ कि अगर आप किसी मीटिंग में हैं और आपको आपके बॉस से डांट पड़ रही है, तो हर किसी का उसको हैंडल करने का तरीका बहुत अलग होता है. कुछ मीटिंग के दौरान उस डांट को भूल जाते हैं, कोई एक दिन में, कोई पांच दिन में. तो हर किसी की सिचुएशन और उसका रिएक्शन डिफरेंट होता है. तो मेरा यही कहना होगा कि जैसे छोटे छोटे टिप्स आपको अंबिका ने दिए हैं कि रिलैक्सेशन टेक्निक्स अपनाइए, डीप ब्रीथिंग करिए, योगा करिए, हेल्दी ईटिंग, बैलेंस डाइट, दीज आर ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट टू you know, cope up with the stress.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And we look forward to have you in our next episode again in Happy Mind, Happy Health series. Aur salam namaste par junne ke liye. Vindhya ma'am, aapka bahut bahut shukriya.
Thank you, Varsha. Thank you. Bye.
So wonderfully described. And with this, we thank both our mentors, Antariksh ji and Ambika ma'am, a big bouquet of thanks and helping us to de-stress ourselves when we are facing stress day in, day out. So a big thank you to Bindya ji as well. And I'm sure we would be able to bring out a world where we are de-stressed and we are capable of helping others who are facing stress. So salam namaste mein happy mind, happy health series mein aaj itna hi. Aur agli baar phir se ek naye topic par hogi baat. Aur wo un saare topics par hogi baat jahan par माइंड हैप्पी होने से बस थोड़ी सी दूरी पर है, और वो दूरी को हम कवर अप करेंगे विद आवर मेंटर्स. अंबिका मैम है, अंतरिक्ष जी है और बिंदिया मैम है, एंड रेडियो सलाम नमस्ते है. सो थैंक यू अगेन मैम, थैंक यू अगेन अंतरिक्ष जी.
थैंक यू सो मच बशा. आई वुड एनकरेज ईच एंड एवरी लिसनर ऑफ आवर्स to ask questions if they have any. Let's all talk together. Let's all figure out a solution, because there is no problem without a solution. So let's take this path of exploration together. Thanks so much, Barsha, for having us on the show. And Antariksh also is waiting to say a huge thank you to all our audience and to you.
Yes.
Thank you, Barsha, for this lovely opportunity to talk to everyone and make a collective so that we can solve our issues, because there is no point not talking about these issues, because these issues are real and we must get them resolved as soon as possible. And I thank you and congratulate your creative team as well for making this possible. Thank you, Barsha.
Thank you so much, sir. And with this, Happy Mind, Happy Health series awaits another episode. और अगली बार मिलने तक खुश रहिए, खुशहाल रहिए और प्यार से रहिए, आबाद रहिए, सुनते रहिए रेडियो सलाम नमस्ते।
सलाम नमस्ते सलाम नमस्ते।